stop staring at the tower cam this morning because it just looks so nice outside.
Yes.
As long as you've got some protection on your arms. I've got a jacket. It's just on my chair.
Yes, definitely, Cynthia. You're going to want a few layers if you are heading outside this afternoon. It looks beautiful, though, and I do recommend, people getting outdoors, enjoy that sunshine because it's not going to last all week. We do have rain in the forecast, but enjoy this on our Fredonia Hotel live tower cam because it's beautiful outside. It is a little chilly, so as Cynthia mentioned, make sure you have that long sleeve outdoors. 45 in Naples, 48 is the current reading in Mount Pleasant, a little closer to the Tyler area. We're at 47 at Tyler Pounds Airport. It's a degree warmer in Lindale, Texas. 47 Nacogdoches, 49 in Rusk. That's in Cherokee County. And then Lufkin, Texas is sitting at 48 degrees and St. Augustine is at 47. But here's that temperature tracker today. It will warm up, so we're not going to remain cold all afternoon. Temperatures will be in the middle 50s by 3 o'clock and getting all the way down to about 30 degrees for tomorrow morning. And this is why. We've got clear skies in the area. I would not be concerned about these high clouds out in the Permian Basin, but what I would be concerned with, and this will significantly impact our weather pattern, is this storm system just off the Bay Area coast. Now, this brings us the chance of rain starting tomorrow night into your Wednesday and Thursday. So let me get you right to Futurecast. This is 8 o'clock. Temperatures are falling into the 40s by then, and then we go through the overnight. Notice we've got clear skies. 8 o'clock tomorrow morning, we're dealing with temperatures in the low to mid 30s, so I do expect a widespread frost, and then the clouds start to move into the area by tomorrow afternoon, so we'll pause this at 6 o'clock once again. High temperatures are really going to struggle to get out of the 40s tomorrow, which is why I do expect high temperatures to probably be about a degree or two colder than what we're going to see this afternoon. But things start to get interesting as we get on into early Wednesday morning. So from about 4 to 7 o'clock when this rain starts to roll in, this is 5 o'clock, we do see the possibility of areas along I-20 and pointing off to the north of seeing perhaps a sleet pellet or two mixed in with that rain we're expecting. So we'll take this a couple more hours. All this is going to start moving off to the northeast. Watch how these temperatures climb over the course of Wednesday morning. They'll already be in the upper 30s. So again, if we do see that rain sleet mix, we're not going to see any accumulations. It's going to be far too warm and surface temperatures are also going to be far too warm to support anything. So cold rain for deep east Texas. For some of our northern counties, from about Cass County over to Hopkins County, we could see a rain snow mix, but again, snow accumulations are highly unlikely. Here are your next 7. Temperatures in the 50s the next couple of days. Rain arrives after midnight. We could see a little bit of that rain snow mix for east Texas Wednesday morning, but it's all rain from Wednesday afternoon into Thursday. But regardless of your in East Texas or deep East Texas, we do start to clear out Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.